Hello students, up to now we have seen about the integrator circuit and differentiator circuits in practical case and ideal case using the operation amplifier or op amp. Now we are going to see about one special type of amplifier which is called as instrumentation amplifier. So this instrumentation amplifier uses the operational amplifier in order to amplify a very weak signals and which is used in all industries in order to amplify the inputs from the transducers. I will explain to each and every one. So let us quickly move into the topic. So instrumentation amplifier. In a number of industrial and consumer applications, one is required to measure and control the physical quantities. In a number of industrial and consumer applications, one is required to measure and control the physical quantities. So in instrumentations or industries, so we have to measure the physical quantities. Suppose if you take one weighing scale, so in the weighing scale, what we are doing, so if we stand on the weighing scale, it is going to measure our weight. So if it is a digital one, so I am talking about the digital weighing scale. In the digital weighing scale, if you stand on the weighing scale, it will show you your weight. How it is possible? Because as you are applying the physical weight onto that, it is converting that physical weight into the electrical quantity, and then that electrical quantity is going to display as a number by using analog to digital converter. Okay, so that we will discuss in the fifth chapter, how the analog inputs are going to be converted into the digital using A2D converters. But now in this case, how the physical quantity is converted into the some electrical analog signal, that we are going to see. So this can be done using the transducer. So what is transducer? The transducer is a device which converts the physical quantity into the electrical quantity. So this physical quantity, like whatever you say, that weight, temperature and pressure, these are the physical quantities that can be converted into the electrical quantity using a device or component which is called as a transducer. Okay, so some typical examples are measurement and control of temperature, humidity, light intensity, water flow, etc. Okay, these are all the examples of the control, how we are controlling and measuring the physical quantities. Suppose if you say the temperature, where we use the temperature measurement and controlling. Suppose if you take your AC, air conditioner, in that if you set some temperature, so if our room temperature is equal to your set temperature, then automatically the AC outdoor unit will stop working. Okay, so this can be done by using a temperature sensor which is used in the air conditioner. Okay, and similarly humidity also, and light intensity control. So based on the light intensity, so the light may increase or decrease its intensity. Okay, suppose we can observe this in our mobile phones. If you go outside of the house, our screen brightness will automatically increases. So when we come from the outside to the inside, automatically the brightness will decreases. So that will happens when we use the intensity sensor, light intensity sensor in the mobile phone, and water flow sensor. So water flowing, so whether the water is flowing in the pipe or not, we can test using some transducers. Okay, the physical quantities are usually measured with the help of a transducers. So we already discussed these physical quantities like the temperature, humidity, light intensity, water flow and pressure, weight, etc. All are measured by using the transducers. Okay, so the output of transducer has to be amplified so that it can drive the indicator or display. So the transducer output is actually a very low amplitude, okay, in order of microvolts or nanovolts. So that much little amount of voltage or electrical signal is not enough is not enough to drive any display or indicating device. Suppose overweight is there, some red color light should show. Okay, so that red color light cannot be driven directly by the transducer itself, because that nano voltage or micro voltage is not sufficient to drive some even LCD also. Okay, so definitely that voltage or that electrical signal which comes from the transducer must be amplified by the amplifier. So as we have already discussed, that the transducer output is a very small amount, so that if we give that output signal to our any amplifier, that may neglect it, because it is a very small amount, so our amplifier may not treat it as a input signal, and which may have attenuated in the input itself. This function is performed by the instrumentation amplifier. Okay, so in order to eliminate that drawback, if you use a normal amplifier, little amount of electrical signal comes from that transducer will be attenuated. So in order to eliminate that attenuation, we have to use a special amplifier called instrumentation amplifier. So the important feature of instrumentation amplifier are high accuracy, high CMRR, common mode rejection ratio, and high gain stability with low temperature coefficient. High gain stability with low temperature coefficient and low output impedance. So these are all the important features of the instrumentation amplifier. One is a high gain accuracy. High gain, the gain of the instrumentation amplifier is very high, and it is also accurate gain. The gain can be accurate, and high CMRR, the common mode rejection ratio, in order to eliminate the common input or same input, so it should have high CMRR. And the gain stability with the low temperature coefficient, so the gain should be constant even though the low temperature coefficient. Okay, so even though that the temperature varies, the gain should not vary with that. And the low output impedance, as a low output impedance we have, then we can drive the many devices. Okay, and let us see the 3 op amp instrumentation amplifier. These instrumentation amplifiers are divided into 2 types based on the uses. One is the 3 op amp instrumentation amplifier, another one is the instrumentation amplifier using transducer bridge. So first we will see about the instrumentation amplifier using the 3 op amp method. So here we are using the 3 operational amplifiers A1, A2 and A3. So A1, A2 are acting like a amplifiers here, and A3 is acting like a differentiator. So if you see, the V1 and V2 are the 2 input voltages for this A1, A2 amplifiers. Okay, see the 3 op amp instrumentation amplifier circuit, and A1, A2 are non-inverting amplifiers here, because these input voltages V1 and V2 has been given to the non-inverting terminals of our operational amplifier. And A3 is the difference amplifier, where A3 is the difference amplifier or subtractor circuit. Okay, so this R1, R2, because of these resistances, it will act like a differentiator. So this differentiator or subtractor will takes the 2 inputs and subtracts the inputs, and then gives us the output signal with some gain. Okay, fine, right? So here we are using the 3 resistors. RF1 is the feedback resistor for the A1, and RF2 is the feedback resistor for the A2 operational amplifier, non-inverting operating amplifier. And here RG is a gain control resistor, which is a variable one. In order to change the gain of this entire circuit, we have to vary only this RG resistance. And here we can say one thing from the virtual ground concept. So the voltage at the 2 inputs of our op amp is equal. So here V1 is the input voltage, then here also we have the voltage of V1. Here V2 is the voltage, therefore this node is also having the same voltage of V2. And here V01 will be the output voltage of the operational amplifier 1, and V02 will be the output voltage for the operational amplifier 2. So let us see the derivation for the output voltage and gain of the instrumentation amplifier using 3 op amps. So I am just redrawing the circuit by eliminating this subtractor, because we already know the derivation for the subtractor. So where R2 by R1 is the gain of this subtractor, and V0 is equal to the difference of input signals, and the sign of the output voltage will be depends upon the input voltage difference. Okay, see, only the input side circuit has been written here. So in this one, A1, A2 are the non-inverting amplifiers, and just I am giving with some notes here: A node, B node, C node, D node. Okay, and here E node, which is the output voltage of A1 op amp, and G is the node here, H and F. Okay, E, F, G, H are the 4 nodes, and the current I will flow, same current I will flow in RF1 resistor, RG resistor and RF2 resistor similarly. And here if you see, the output of op amp A1 is V01 voltage, and the output of op amp 2 A2 is V02, like this. Okay, therefore the output voltage V0 is equal to R2 by R1 into V02 minus V01. So what is this output? Entire output of our instrumentation amplifier, which is output from the differentiator circuit. See this one, V0. Okay, V0 is equal to V01 here. The voltage at this node is V01, just we have seen. And voltage at this node is V02. So V02 minus V01 will be the difference voltage, that will be multiplied with the gain of the subtractor R2 by R1. See, so V0 is equal to gain R2 by R1 of the subtractor or differentiator circuit into V02 minus P01. And applying Ohm's law between the nodes E and F, we get, if you apply the Ohm's law between the E and F nodes, then we can write the I current equation. I is equal to V01 minus V02 by RF plus RG plus RF2. So here E and F nodes are here. In between these, I current is flowing. This I current equation, voltage divided by the resistances. So voltage between the nodes is V01 minus V02 divided by the total resistance RF1 plus RG plus RF2. So if you take the RF1 is equal to RF2, RF1 is equal to RF2 is equal to RF, then this RF1 and RF2 will become as RF only. Okay, RF plus RF is equal to 2RF. Therefore, I can be written as I is equal to V01 minus V02 divided by 2RF plus RG. Now, from the observation of nodes G and H, if you observe the G and H nodes, the current I can be written as, I current can be written as Vg minus Vh divided by the Rg, the voltage between the two nodes divided by the resistance Rg. So which can be written as V1 minus V2 by Rg, V1 minus V2 by Rg. How it will be? Because the voltage at the two input terminals of op amp is same according to the virtual ground. So Vg is equal to V1 and Vh is equal to V2. So Va is equal to Vb and Vc is equal to Vd. Like that we have written this circuit. Okay. So equating the two equations for the I current. So I current already we written like V01 minus V02 by 2RF plus RG, which is equal to this equation V1 minus V2 by RG. And rearrange the equation. So V02 minus V01 by 2RF plus RG is equal to V1 minus V2 by RG. Okay, so V02 minus V01 is equal to 2RF plus RG into V2 minus V1 divided by the RG. So actually there is a minus here, just indicate that. Okay, so V2 minus V1 we got. V02 minus V01 is equal to 2 into RF plus RG into V2 minus V1 by RG. And we know that the entire output voltage of the 3 op-amp instrumentation amplifier is R2 by R1 into V02 minus V01. So just now we calculated V02 minus V01 equation, so that we are substituting the value. So V0 is equal to R2 by R1 into this V02 minus V01 can be written as 2RF plus RG by RG into V2 minus V1. Now the output voltage is equal to R2 by R1 into 1 plus here RG by RG will becomes 1 plus 2RF by RG into V2 minus V1. This is our output voltage of our instrumentation amplifier using 3 op-amp method. See, by just varying the value of RG, we can get the different gains. So if you vary this RG resistance, then we can get the different gains to our differential voltage V2 minus V1. Okay, so like that, even though the voltage V2 minus V1 is very small, so that is getting multiplied by the two gains. One is the gain of the subtractor, another one is the gain of this circuit, this non-inverting amplifier circuits, 1 plus 2RF by RG into V2 minus V1. Advantages of instrumentation amplifier with RG: the gain can be easily varied. Okay, by using a single resistor RG, we can easily vary the output voltage, and the gain can be made stable by selecting high quality resistances. So if you select the high quality resistances, then the gain can be easily maintained as a constant or stable. Okay, the input impedance is very high because we are using the two operational amplifiers right at the input side, so the gain is very high, and the output impedance is very low, so that we can drive the number of devices. The CMRR of the op amp A3 is very high, and most of the common mode signals will be rejected. So as the differentiator or last subtractor amplifier has a high CMRR, then it can able to eliminate the common mode signals. So these are all the advantages of the instrumentation amplifier. So let us see the another type of instrumentation amplifier, so which is instrumentation amplifier using transducer bridge. So this is one of the most widely used instrumentation amplifier in the industries. So this is the block diagram for the instrumentation amplifier using transducer bridge. Here we use one bridge circuit. Okay, so in this, one of the branch has been given with the transducer. One of the branch has been given with the transducer. In this case, it is a resistive transducer network. So which converts the physical quantity into the variation in the resistance. Okay, if you use the thermistor, which has a negative temperature coefficient, like that we can use here. Okay, any component we can use, and here we will apply some DC voltage in order to operate this bridge network, which is VDC or V. Here it can be represented like V or VDC, whatever it is, and this bridge output can be given to the 3 op amp instrumentation amplifier, and thereafter this circuit, it will be given to drive the circuit, one more circuit, or it can be given to the indicator or display devices. The single chip instrumentation amplifiers such as AD521, AD524 and LH0036 and LH0037 are used in the industries. This entire circuit will be implemented, is available in IC format, single IC format, which is AD521, AD524 and LH0036 and LH0037. These are all the some of the instrumentation amplifier ICs numbers. Okay, let us see how it will be after this circuit. See, this is the transducer bridge, and then this is given to the 3 op amp instrumentation amplifier here. So 1 op amp, 2 op amp, 2 op amp, 3, and here this op amp 3 output has been given to one display device, so which is showing the difference between these voltages. Okay, so initially the bridge is in the balanced condition. The bridge will be in the balanced condition, At that time, the output voltage from the bridge is zero. Therefore, no output will be there to the display device. In any case, like a transducer device will vary its resistance. Suppose it is varying based on the temperature, means if the room temperature varies, then what happens? Automatically, this resistance will be varied. If that resistance varies, then the bridge becomes unbalanced, and which gives some error voltage VAB. VAB is the error voltage from the bridge. So when the VAB will come? When the bridge becomes unbalanced. So bridge becomes unbalanced means that because of some external factors, this resistance is getting varied. Suppose it may be the temperature, okay, or it may be some pressure sensor or pressure transducer, or it may be a weight transducer like that. Okay, so the VAB voltage will get generated when the bridge becomes unbalanced. The change in the resistance is RT plus R minus delta R. RT is the original resistance at the room temperature, and plus R minus delta R, because of the change in the temperature, the resistance has been changed with delta R. Delta R is a change in the resistance. Therefore, some VAB will be generated, and this VAB is given to the buffer amplifiers or of A1, A2. So here A1 and A2 are acting like a non-inverting buffers, so which transfer the signal from the bridge to the subtractor circuit. That's it. It won't do any amplification here. So these A1 and A2 will propagate the same input voltage to the output voltage. VAB is equal to VAB here also. And this A3 is acting like a subtractor or a differentiator circuit, which provides a gain of R2 by R1 into VAB. Okay, the V0 is equal to the gain of the differentiator circuit R2 by R1 into the input voltage VAB. So that will be given to the load or display device here. So the V0 voltage is equal to the gain A into delta R divided by 4R into VDC. Okay, so V0 is equal to A into delta R divided by 4R into VDC. Delta R is the change in the resistance. Here RA, RB, RC is equal to R only. Okay, and A is the gain of the instrumentation amplifier or this one subtractor device. So VDC is the applied input DC voltage to the bridge network. The circuit uses a resistive transducer whose resistance changes as a function of the physical quantity to be measured. So as we have already discussed, that transducer resistance will vary with the physical quantity to be measured, and the bridge is initially balanced by the DC supply voltage VDC, so that V1 is equal to V2. So initially the bridge is balanced at certain conditions, okay, as per the physical quantity changes. So the resistance RT of the transducer also changes, which causing unbalance in the bridge, V1 not equal to the V2. The differential voltage now gets amplified by the 3 op amp differential instrumentation amplifier. There are the number of differential applications of instrumentation amplifier with a transducer bridge, such as temperature indicator, temperature controller, and the light intensity meter, etc. So we already seen some weighing scales also will work on that. Okay, so these are all the applications of using the instrumentation amplifier. Okay, so what is happening here? See, when we go here, so initially the bridge is getting balanced at certain conditions. After that, if the physical quantity varies, or else the temperature is a physical quantity, if that varies, then the bridge becomes unbalanced, which gives some error voltage VAB. This VAB will be amplified by the subtractor, and which will be given to the indicator circuit. This indicator will work only when the bridge becomes unbalanced, otherwise it will show the zero output, because at bridge balanced condition VAB is equal to zero. Therefore, the V0 is equal to gain into the change in the resistance occurred due to the physical quantity divided by 4R into VDC. Okay, this is about the instrumentation amplifier. So it has many applications: temperature indicator, temperature controller, light intensity meter, etc. In the next class, we are going to see about the voltage to current converter and current to voltage converters.